military aid or big, not for military.
How do you feel about increased military aid to South Vietnam?
I'd be opposed to it altogether. I think we've put far too much military aid into Vietnam.
How about humanitarian aid?
That's a different matter. I think that we should give humanitarian aid wherever possible during these days.
I think increased military aid to South Vietnam is a lost cause. I think that we ought to give them humanitarian aid when the time is chosen by Congress, but more military action I'm against.
Seems to me it's a little late now. They need food and things like that, but as far as military, it seems to me it's a little late.
I don't think that it really would do any good. I feel that we've given enough money already. It's hurt our country, and they haven't done too well with what they've had already.
How about humanitarian aid?
Well, the humanitarian part of me says yes, but again, I'm not so sure that they would do the right things with it and would be managed well, suit the purpose.
Well, I think we've spent enough over there, and I think that someone else could divvy up a little bit too, but I don't think it should be increased anymore now. It's way out of line.
I think we have a certain obligation over there to help the refugees and the orphans. But I can't see any more military aid. I think it's money down the rat hole.
After a 9-year study, the state auditor's report indicates that state travel increased some 400% between 1966 and last year. Of the $760,000 tax dollars that were spent for out-of-state travel in 1974, none of it included the cost of the employee's salary. The reasons for the increase, according to State Auditor Smith, are due in large part to the number of federal and state programs.
Well, I attribute it to many things. One is the federal government with their bureaucracy and their funding want to have so many schools of instruction and conferences. I attribute the fact that higher cost of living outside the state, but the record also shows that it's lots of folks like to take an out-of-state trip, and it's gone up way over $100,000, and that's more than the average cost of inflation.
What do you think should be done to curtail the amount of trips?
Number one, make it a line item budget, so-called, make them account for it in advance, make some kind of prediction, projections, I should say. Secondly, send some cassettes with, and let someone bring back some reports and things like that.
Even though Smith thinks the state is spending too much money for out-of-state travel, he says it could have been worse, up to $1 million, if the Executive Council had not put the lid on the amount of travel requests last year. From the Iowa State House, this is Don Keeler reporting. During the height of the Indochina conflict, over 24,000 Iowans were drafted into service, many of whom saw action in Vietnam, Cambodia, and Laos. But under a bill proposed by Representative Greg Cusack, even if there are more undeclared wars, Iowans will be prohibited from serving.
I feel very strongly that in a future war, hopefully there won't be one, but if there is one where the Congress doesn't have the courage to declare war, as they're supposed to do under the Constitution, that we shouldn't allow our Iowa people to be drafted and killed in a war that's not legally declared. And the bill says the Attorney General would have the authority to intervene on behalf of Iowa citizens drafted under that kind of circumstance.
Representative Cusack, what about the constitutional issue involved in this bill?
Well, I think, frankly, no one knows. Again, it has been tested in the courts once. That was when it was first introduced in Massachusetts, and the courts found that it was, the Massachusetts court, it was not constitutional. But again, I have a feeling that the issue is based on federal law, our most basic law, which is the Constitution. And it says that if the Congress acts in contravention of that law by not declaring war, that the Attorney General of the states has a right to act on behalf of the state citizens. I think that's probably correct. And I think that a court might now find, since we're in between wars, hopefully, that it would be a constitutional act.
774 Iowans were listed as killed or missing in action in Indochina, statistics that Representative Cusack's hope will never be repeated if his bill is passed by the Iowa legislature. From the Capitol in Des Moines, this is Don Keeler reporting.